Hey everybody, welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Zelda The Minish Cap. It is Cute Man talking to Mike once more. I wish I chose a short lead. I want it to be a short lead easier. It's my new favorite word, even though it's not a word. Easier. Anyways, last time we did a lot of stuff, actually. My memory is very poor tonight, so don't ask me to describe what stuff we did in the last episode. The response you'll get is stuff. Anyways, we are in search of the wind element. So, yes. Oh, balls, Armos. I believe that's what they're called. I can't remember. Hey, it just tried to kill me. What a jerk. By the Minish, because if they are, I'm gonna be so sad. They were. What? Oh, hey, kill some of these. Why'd you do that, though? They're trying to kill me now. I'm not doing anything wrong. Am I? If I am, I'm not aware of it. Okay, my mouse is sliding all over the place because I'm sitting on my knees. That sentence makes no sense to anyone who saw me. Especially since it wasn't even true. Apparently I'm a chronic liar. I'm very lazy. I usually record these videos in bed. I'm usually lying down. I have a laptop desk, which I have my laptop on for all my recording shenanigans. And usually I'm just sitting upright with my back against the wall, right now I'm lying on my back, which means that the keyboard desk is all but balancing on my knees. My mouse is sliding everywhere. I love the gold attack thing. Oh sweet, that's amazing. In the last episode... Where was I going? Alright, near the end of the last episode we found a sword master. We got all 7 tiger scrolls, we have 4 bows. It's not necessary to beat the game, but I'm probably gonna go and look into getting all of those because I want to. For that matter, there are a few extra sword masters, blade masters that I want to find. Because things they teach are not really finishing the game, but make it much less irritating. Like reducing the time to charge the spin attack on himself, I believe. Which I could do with, but I don't like how long it takes to charge each of those. Not the door, but you know what I mean. The rest of them, I'm pretty sure if you kill them, then that'll be up over there. And I don't know what's in there, because I forget, but I want in there. Oh, sweet. many mysterious shells do I have? Good lord. 700. I don't know if I'm gonna be running out of mysterious shells anytime soon, guys. Don't have a lot of them anyway. It's not like I have a lot of them. The OCD kicks in. Oh hey! Until now is that I'm playing the PAL version of the game, so some of the text is different to the NTSC or North American version. Like the dog being called Porkin instead of Fifi or Fifi. Fifi, wow, I think so. That's because I'm playing the PAL version. The gameplay is the same, just text. Actually, hang on. Just a second, because I'm pretty sure there's more to it than that. Well, we actually witnessed one of the differences earlier without me even realizing it. The Goron cave, in every version except the European version, there's two whirlwinds, and the European version there's just one. There's a gameplay change later on, which we'll be going, which I'll go over when I get there. And there's a glitch, there's a glitch involving one of the dungeon items in the dungeon after this one. And one last thing, this is a pretty big one actually, I'm reading this from the Cutting Room Floor website for anyone who cares about prototyping stuff like I do. In the Japanese and North American version, this is word for word, cause, yeah, I'm tired. You can buy a bomb bag for 600 rupees at Stockwell's after having bought the boomerang. There's no way to obtain the bigger bomb bag in the European version. I believe this bomb bag holds like 99 friggin' bombs, so I could do with that, but apparently Albert can't get it. I can live with that. Anyways, I should probably mention it. This is my least favorite dungeon in the game. Least favorite dungeon in the game. These guys are tall, but I don't like them. They jump over my sword. It makes me sad. I hate bats in general. And this is also the dungeon I was talking about, where you choose the wrong door when you have... choose the wrong locked door when you have a key, and you're screwed. Fairly confident as this one, and I'm fairly confident that it is indeed a unbeatable scenario. Scenario? Yes. I'm fairly sure it's an unbeatable scenario if you get the wrong door. Not entirely sure, so don't quote me on that, but I could beat it when I picked the wrong door. And I tried for quite a while. Damn it! Uh-oh. Got that up. Yeah, it's like... I'm pretty sure that... I can't remember if those things are called... what they're called. I want to say anti-fairy, but I'm not sure. I believe you can weapon with... or an optional weapon, which is what the Tangle side quest is for. You can, kill those. Don't quote me on that, because I'm not sure. Oh, balls. Oh, come on! I hate this part. Thank God you can hold out the bow. Oh yeah, did I mention that this part isn't even necessary anyway? This is just... it gives you the compass, I believe. Uh-oh. Oh, balls. It's either the compass or the map. I think it's the compass. Called it. That's very useful considering I don't have the map yet. I am the best Legend of Zelda player who has ever lived. Okay, look, more of the duplication time. Snakes! Cool, I can't be a fair shot with a bow once in a while. Anyway, we have lots of moves. We need to prepare some parts. The only thing I don't like about the presentation is you can't control the whole thing. Hello. It wasn't your imagination. Jeez. You don't need it. Take my word for it. Now, I can't... Hello, what's this? Oh! There was a heart piece in there. Find a way to get that. Oh, I don't want this. I would even go as far as saying I hate them more in this game than I did in Link to the Past, which is saying a lot. Well, I can't remember. Wait, no. I'm thinking of a different enemy in Link to the Past. The ones that just went at angles around the room. Hated those guys. Not sure if I hate them more or these guys more. Because these guys were with the Don't tell me I have to open the door again. If I do, I'm gonna be really close. Okay, good. I lost my train of thought now. Hang on, I need to sit up. Guys in Link to the Past, they were a bit unpredictable and really fast, which made them annoying. These guys electrocute you when you're standing next to them, not on the same spot. At least that's the impression I always got, and I do not like that. I do not agree. To use magic for cloning floors again. And this jerk's blocking one of them. Crazy insolence. There's no need to be on the other one, but we can't get it. Now we can. Up, go up. Oh, that doesn't. Sorry, I'm not very patient tonight. This is a very good move today for no real reason. I want to try something here, because there was a heart piece we saw earlier. Oh my god, he falls like a rock. The key won't decay, I know that much. Sweet, that's it, that is how you did it. That was so stupid, I actually didn't know that's how you got it. Which of these blocks moves? Oh, come on, that's it, what? Oh, so none of them move? Yep, there we go. Hate that thing. Alright, well now we have two keys at least. Main door? Stairs going up. Okay. The layout of this dungeon is always confusing to high hell. Not now! First time I played. Because I'm fairly sure that you need two keys over on this one. And anyone still have the promise? Open the door on the right. Don't quote me. You open the door on the right first, then I'm pretty sure you don't get another key. I'm not entirely clear on that. Don't bother quoting me, please. I don't even much. I don't have any goddamn idea what I'm talking about, honestly. Not the first time I was stuck and couldn't get past there. The only way I managed to get past it was by opening the other door the first time. Already? Oh god! Thank you for the reaction time, video game. There's something along the wall. Them all hit. Yeah, you get them on this side. You can get a key on the other side, but the problem is you need moments to get it. So I believe this is the door on the other side that you needed a key for. What happened was, I went and opened the right door, as in the door that's on the right, not the correct door, and, used the other key there, because I need the moments to get the other key on that side, couldn't do it. We barely made it. Oh, fantastic. best destroying every stage in all of the chapter. And the, my favorite has except that the one after the next one is pretty goddamn long. I'm probably gonna be swearing a lot. I don't think you can even attack anything when you're small and you have... You can attack anything with the sword, can I? I need the door open, don't I? I do. I hate this dungeon. I'll get through this door first. Yeah, see, there we go, that door. I believe what happened was, I meant to use the key on there. Through there, and then... enough about failing the simple part. Oh great, speaking of failing the simple part. I do not like how easy it is for the Link apparitions to disappear like that. And I really hate how long it takes to charge this thing. Oh my god! Seconds, but I don't care what anyone else thinks, that's longer than it should take. Okay. Oh, I just noticed the cartoon expression with Link's eyes. It shows up for like half a frame when he falls in the pit. That's funny. I know where to get the key, so this all works out. Sorry about that, I wasn't paying attention. Okay, that was cool. Doesn't really serve much either. Oh my god. I'm tired apparently. And apparently I'm still going even though the cinema's just about done. Oh boy. Yeah. This part of the game isn't... That part isn't actually quite as hard as it looks. Oh yeah, here we go. Okay, no know, I really can't remember what I did to make the game unwinnable for me now. You got a small key. I really can't remember now, but I know I did something. Something horrible. I want to see, are there any secrets in this area? I can see the head of Batman in there. Ow! Ow! Stop electrocuting me. Okay. Instead of missing him like I did. Jump the door. Drop down the hole on the right, because I need to get the big key. Yep. Though we haven't seen any big doors yet. But we will need the big key, trust me. Unless you're me and are going to take the universe. There's some other rooms where you can get bonuses and stuff from the morbids. And you can hear my sleep deprivation speaking for itself. Magic fireballs. Magic fireballs. Not just any ordinary fireballs, magic ones. Gotta get some of these! Huzzah! I don't like how this dirt resets every time you leave a room. Okay, I think that's actually a good place to stop. Next time on Let's Play The Legend of Zelda, The Minish Cap, we will finish up this dungeon and I will be happy. Bye guys.